Hello and welcome, Retrovirus peeps. Hey, we've got the rifle selected today, and let's take a look at the way this bad boy works. Why am I not? There we go. And you can see here we've got a reticle and we've got a white line in the middle of it. Now, you can see that the white lines lengthen as we get further away. So when I'm targeting up really close here, you can see the white lines are almost non-existent. And when I'm super close, they disappear completely. So these tell us how much damage I'll actually do at range with this tool, with the rifle, if I scan and hit at the same time. Now, so the key thing with the rifle, if you have good aim, is actually to be scanning ahead of when you fire so that when your rifle round arrives, the scan arrives at the same time to provide maximum damage. Now, the rifle shots themselves do 42 units damage. But if you manage to scan at exactly the same time, then what you'll see is 99 damage on a normal agent. Now, that's reasonably impressive. In fact, I'd say it's absolutely devastating. And it's going to be an awful lot easier for people using a mouse to use the rifle than it is for people like me who have a really hard time aiming with the joystick. So my method of aiming, I can't actually scan before I fire effectively because what I tend to do is just slowly move the reticle around and wait for the target to move underneath it before I fire. So I'm not actually aiming and then firing. I'm drifting and waiting. And this seems to be about the only way I can really aim anything that's hit scan in this game, or indeed any game online. Now, the very interesting thing about the net code for Retrovirus is that it is partly client server and partly peer-to-peer. So what that means is that every peer makes a connection to the server, and ultimately that the server decides all of the but you also make a peer-to-peer connection with everybody in the game. And if your peer-to-peer connection is better than your client server connection, then it will use that connection. Now, this can consume a little bit of bandwidth. I haven't done an awful lot of testing as yet. But what it means is that when you're playing Retrovirus, you should, even at reasonably high pings of like 150, 200, so we want to keep away from the guy with the shotgun because the shotgun up close is just lethal. So even at high pings, even at high pings, you should be able to aim at the agent, shoot, fire, and kill. See, I don't have. I'm running low on juice now. God, come on. Now, for mouse users using the rifle, you may be able to become very, very accurate with this and extremely lethal. Mainly because aiming around the reticle point, around the center when your mouse is almost not moving, is much, much easier than with the joystick. Particularly if you have drivers which allow you to set mouse acceleration so that you can set the initial movement very low, but then apply a lot of acceleration. Now, if you can do that, then close to the reticle point your aim is going to be extremely accurate, but you'll be able to turn very quickly indeed. I'm going to show you a trick that I found out as well. Geez, we're down to 15 frames a second. No wonder it's not that easy to aim and fire. Come on, get away from that guy. Anything. It'd be nice to have a couple of shots up the spout, wouldn't it? Kill that guy. So the rifle is very powerful provided you can scan ahead or that you actually remember to scan. Now up close, when we see none of these no white lines on the reticle, we're not actually doing any increased damage by scanning the residue that we've pasted on someone with this thing. So if you do get up close and personal with someone, then you have to hit them a lot more. Ooh. So three times you'll have to hit an agent on 100. So I guess the key thing with the rifle is to be patient, because you only get a few rounds before you're out of juice. And and you really got to take your time and aim well. So I hope you enjoyed our little look at the rifle.